Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2352, Lonely Book Signings, and a faster way to generate 729 combos. Ah, this story's been in the news. Cleveland author Chelsea Banning had a book signing outside of Cleveland. 37 people said they were going, and only two people signed up to the author signing. She's gotten so many responses from authors who have had similar horror stories. Boy, and it took me back to October 2003. I was in Akron, Ohio, and we booked this book signing in Manhattan at the Computer Bookworks. It was a great computer bookstore right in New York City. The whole family went up. Just a lot of planning and expense, and exactly one person, Dave from Connecticut. Hey, Dave. Showed up at that book signing. So, Chelsea, don't feel bad. Two seems like a huge group. Also, out in Laguna Beach, actually, this was Irvine, the Irvine SciTech bookstore. We had three people, plus a girlfriend and a kid, show up for this signing. So far more successful, although it's funny, about 4 months later, those books were sold through the cash register at the bookstore, and I get a letter saying that they were bankrupt and could not pay. Oh well. Everyone has their horrible book signing stories. All right, the story for today. In episode 2351, I built this huge model, spent 15 minutes to predict that perhaps 28.4% of the World Cup groups would end up in a tie. And here to report that there were three of the eight ended up with a tiebreaker, so equal 3 divided by 8 is 37.5%. So order of magnitude, pretty close to the prediction. But the real reason I'm here today is during the process of demonstrating that, I had to build these 729 combinations where for each of the six games in a group, we had to iterate through the various values of 0 for a draw, 1 for the team on the top wins, 2 for the team on the side wins, and I came up with the best method I could think of by typing 0, 1, 2, and then this formula here, and then all of the formulas to the left of that using this formula here, right? It was ugly, but it worked. But of course, there are better ways to do that. Thanks to MrExcel LAMBDA for giving us this single cell formula for generating the entire sequence like that. And then also a shout out to Kyle. Kyle, who came up with another clever use for the base function. We've used base on the podcast before. Mordecai from New York was using base to do something cool. And Kyle's idea was to take the base of all the numbers from 0 through 728 using base 3. So in base 3, the only digits are 0, 1, and 2, and make it be a 6-digit string. And sure enough, that works. All right, so I took Kyle's formula and changed it a little bit. I put the sequence function inside. I need 729 rows, one column, starting at 0, jumping by 1. Show that in base 3 with 6 digits all the time. And there's the 6 results of the games in the group. So a couple of great updates there. I will be on vacation next week, so look for something to come back in the podcast. Maybe around the week of December 22nd. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.